Hey, I'm Pastor Stephen. Welcome back to our study as we continue in the book of Colossians. Today, we're going to wrap up with chapter 4 and finish out this study as we continue to talk about what it means to center our lives around Christ. This study has had one purpose, simply to realize what a Christ-centered life looks like. Over the past several weeks, we have discussed what it means to please God, to know Christ, how to be victorious through Christ, and what it means to involve Jesus in our everyday relationships. As we dive into chapter 4, we're going to discuss what it means to have Christ in our conversations. And basically put, Christ needs to be clear in our conversations. A life that is centered around Christ will speak life into others. So we're only going to look at two verses today. We're going to look at verses 5 and 6. So why don't you go ahead and read that with me? We're going to start in verse 5, and this is what it says. Paul says, "Live wisely among those who are not believers, and make the most of every opportunity. Let your conversation be gracious and attractive, so that you will have the right response for everyone." As we unpack these two verses, we begin to find out a few things. And the first thing we find out is that your life validates your voice. See, Paul says or suggests that we live wisely among those who are not believers. As you might know, there are so many things going on in our culture, in our world today. And there's a war that we talk about, a political war. There's a war on racism, and there's Black Lives Matters, all lives matters slogans going on. One of the things hashtags I've found is that it goes around that it says this, hashtag your voice matters. So if you look at each picture or post, they all have a common goal: to let the world know their opinion or thoughts concerning politics, racism, sexual identity, earth conservation, animal rights. You name the agenda, this hashtag goes with it. I don't want to downplay any of these, but what I want to say is that if you want a voice that matters, then your life needs to be able to validate what you have to say, especially when it comes to Christ or the gospel. So why live wisely? Why does he say live wisely? And he says among those who what? Are not believers. There's a saying that says, don't give your enemy ammunition. People who do not believe are watching and waiting for you to mess up, for me to mess up. So when that happens, they will immediately jump up, point the finger, and say, see, I told you that this Christianity thing was a joke. See, it takes one moment to undo any attempt at sharing the gospel. It is a tainted testimony that derails the message of the gospel. So be smart, he says, live wisely. Validate your voice by living a life that reflects Jesus. And we do that by making sure that we reflect Christ in our actions, in our decisions, in our choices, and most of all, in what we say. So if we're going to live a life that has a voice that matters, you've got to validate your voice with your choices, with your actions, and all of that should be backed up by how you live your life. And if Christ is in your conversations, if you are centering your life around Christ, and if you go back to the last several weeks as we talked about how Christ is the only one that completes us, that we can overcome sin, we can overcome the temptation and the battles that we endure through Christ, and that Christ is creating us, is recreating us, he's making us into a new creation. If we follow that example that Christ has done on the cross, then we begin to center our lives around Christ and we make Christ our primary focus. See, in Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 and 2, it talks about running your race, it talks about running your race, right? And so we do that, he says, by laying aside the sin and the weight of temptation that trips us up or ensnares us, right? And we run our race with patience. How do we do that? By focusing on Christ, by keeping our eyes on Jesus. It says, for the joy of the cross was before him. He endured it because it was a joy for him to do that. He loved you and I so much that he died on the cross for our sins. And that is the example for us to follow. So if you want to validate your voice, if you want to live wisely among those who are not believers, then you need to back up your message with a life that follows that. So what does that mean? So that means this. It's your testimony, right? If you want to tell people about how Christ has changed your life, then you've got to live differently than those who live in this world. And if you constantly are doing the same things, being caught up in the same sin, the same trap, the same snares that everybody else is, the people that you're trying to reach, they're going to look at you and say, why should I be any different when you are exactly the same as me? See, it is a tainted testimony that derails the message of the gospel. Be smart, live wise, validate your voice by living a life that reflects Jesus. So he goes on in verse 5 and he says this, not only should you live wisely among those who are not believers, but make the most of every opportunity. You must be open to every opportunity. Thomas Edison said this, most people miss opportunity because it is dressed in overalls and looks like work. We can live our lives and be blind to the opportunities that we have, or we can make the most of where we are with what we have to make an impact for the cause of Christ. A Christ-centered life will be eager to use the opportunities available to share Jesus with anyone and everyone. I had a good friend, some of you have heard the story and heard me talk about him. His name was Jimmy, and he was the epitome of this verse. He made the most of every opportunity he had. I remember countless times that we would go through the drive-thru, and 10 to 15 minutes later, as cars are honking and people are getting mad, he's sharing Jesus with the McDonald's employee that's trying to give him his food. When is the last time you share Jesus with anyone? I can guarantee you it is not because you did not have an opportunity. Christ has placed the people in your life for a reason, and your job is to cultivate conversations about Christ with them. So think about it. How many times do you share Jesus? How many times have you shared Jesus? When is the last time that you have cultivated a conversation about Christ? So, not only should you validate your voice by living a life that reflects Christ, and not only should you be open to every opportunity, he goes into verse 6, your message must be motivated. Look at what he says in verse 6. Let your conversation be gracious and attractive so that you have the right response for everyone. Let your conversation be full of grace, he says, and attractive. What does it mean for our conversation to be full of grace and attractive? We have to speak with grace and passion. Your message must be motivated by grace and passionate to attract others to Christ. Let people know God is gracious. Speak in a way that displays the message of grace in your life. Has God changed you? Has Jesus saved you? Are you motivated by what Christ did on the cross? And then share it. Share it with others with passion. One of the hardest things is to see someone that is not passionate about what Christ has done for them. Especially if you're an unbeliever. Put yourself in the shoes of someone who is not a believer. If someone came up to you and said, hey, you need to have a relationship with Jesus. The Bible says you're a sinner and you need to be saved. Why? Why do I need to be saved? Right? What's the point? What's the point of Christianity? What's the meaning or the motivation behind Christianity? So people listen to passion, but are apathetic towards a message that has no authority. Let people know that you mean what you say and you genuinely care about the message that you are delivering. Think about what God has done for you. Think about all the things that Christ has done for you. Romans 5:8, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. why we were sinners, why we were enemies with God, when we didn't deserve it, Christ still went to the cross and he died on our death sentence because of our guilt, because of our sin, for the consequences of our actions and our choices. Christ died for us. If that does not motivate you, I don't know what else will. Romans chapter 12 says that we need to live our lives as a living sacrifice, to present our bodies as a living sacrifice to God, because this is your reasonable service. It is only reasonable to live for Christ because he died for you. See, your response must reveal the truth about Jesus, and you must have a motivated message that is backed up by the truth. In your conversations, the truth must be present. So this means that you need to know the truth. Jesus said this in John chapter 8, verse 32, it says this, "Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." If you want a voice that matters, validate it with a life that reflects Christ. If you want a message that is motivated, speak with grace and passion and make the most of every opportunity and be ready to respond with the truth of Jesus. That is how you center your conversations around Christ. Christ needs to be clear in our conversations. We need to know the truth. We need to present the truth. And you cannot present the truth if your life is not backing that up. If you don't live by what Christ is saying for you to do, if you do not have a life that follows the message of Christ, you're not going to be able to present the gospel to anybody because no one is going to listen to what you have to say. See, that is the problem with today. Everybody has a voice. Everybody wants to say something, but not everybody has a life that is able to back up their voice. They do not have a life that validates their voice. They have opportunities, but they don't back it up with their life. And so you have to have a life that backs up what you say. And when you have a life that backs up what you say, people will take notice and they will listen because you will have an opportunity and there will be opportunities. Right now, I guarantee there is somebody that you have an opportunity to share the gospel with. And when you share the gospel with them, do it with passion. Do it with grace. That person might have messed up. That person might be the most vile sinner that you know, the most wicked person on the face of the planet. But remember, God shows grace beyond anything we could ever say or we could ever do. So when we're sharing the message of Christ, we cannot pick and choose who it goes to. We must show grace to all people and do it with passion. Be motivated by what Christ did for you and what Christ can do for them. And when you do that, you're going to center your conversations around Christ. And when your conversations are centered around Christ, your life is going to be centered around Christ. So thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate every one of you who watches these videos. My prayer is that something through this study has helped your relationship with Christ. Hopefully you can clearly see that a life that is centered around Christ is a life that is completely victorious and validated through Jesus. As we close the book of Colossians, we're going to turn our attention now to the book of Galatians next week as we discover what it means to live free in Christ and to live in that freedom that Christ has called us to. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. Have a good day, and we'll see you next week.